So without further ado, I believe we will kick off the meeting. And our first speaker should be Dr. Zarev. Now, I met this guy in Bulgaria, in Ankara, and he's the most interesting guy in the hair transplant world. And the meeting in Ankara was his very first hair transplant conference ever. And this guy blew me away. So I'm really happy to have him here. And he's more or less my featured speaker. Come on.
Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Zarev from Bulgaria. I have been doing hair transplant for the last 9 years. And this is my first participation in such a meeting. First, I want to thank Dr. Cole for the invitation. About 6 months ago, he saw some of my results, and for this reason I'm here before you now. So, FUE Super Giga Sessions, up to 14,000 grafts. This is the title of my presentation. Sounds unrealistic, but it's quite possible. Of course, it's possible when the patients have enough follicular units in the donor areas and pure follicular units are extracted without or with minimal surrounding tissue. Right at the beginning of my practice, I saw that standard manual and motorized FUE techniques impose some limitation, which in many cases do not allow such results. So over 5 years ago, I started developing a technique and equipment to achieve my goals. When I managed to do that, I can extract up to 60% from the donor area without significantly affecting their visual density and leaving no noticeable scars on the skin. This makes it possible to actually redistribute the available hair and to achieve natural visual density even in a high degree of androgenic alopecia. So these are some of my cases with more than 10,000 grafts. If necessary, up to 14,000 grafts can be transplanted in some of them. I will present you in detail two of these cases, one with short hair in the donor area after surgery and one with long hair. This is the first case with total of 12,620 grafts. The result was achieved in two interventions. During the first intervention, in two surgical days, I transplanted 9,350 grafts. 13 months later, in one surgical day, I transplanted another 3,270 grafts. The final result is 7 months after the second surgery. This is the status of the patient before surgery, after marking the donor area and recipient. Again, the status of the patient. And this is a detailed information about the donor and the recipient area. You can see later. This is the recipient area of the patient with microcamera photos. And this is a detailed information about the high and low part of occipital area of the patient. You can see the number of graft per square centimeter, the number of hair in the follicle units, hair thickness, hair and cut again. The same information of the temporal area. And this is a detailed information about the first surgical day. In the first part of the surgery, I extracted 4,670 grafts from the right part of the donor area, and after 1 hour of rest, I implanted this amount in the back part of the recipient area. The total surgical time was 11 hours. On the second surgical day, I extracted 4,680 grafts from the left part of the donor area, and after 1 hour of rest, I implanted this amount in the front part of the recipient area. These are some of the grafts on this patient. And this is the recipient area on the next surgical day. You can see the microcamera photos from hairline, middle and back part of the recipient area. And this is the donor area on the day after surgery. You can see the contact between the donor and the recipient area. On the microcamera photos, you can see the high contraction rate of the surgical wounds when working with small diameter punch. This makes it possible to achieve high extraction rate during the intervention. Again, the donor area, left and right temporal. This is the recipient area 8 days after the intervention with microcamera photos. And this is the donor area 8 days after the surgery. Again, the contact between the donor and the recipient area. And on the microcamera photos, you can see the healing process of the surgical wounds 8 days after surgery. Again, the donor area. And this is the progress of the patient in the first 7 months after the transplantation of 9,350 grafts. The result, 7 months after the surgery, after the first surgery. This is the status immediately before the second surgery, 33 months later, and microcamera photos again. And this is the detailed information about the second surgery. During this intervention, I transplanted 3,270 grafts, and total surgical time was 9 hours and 30 minutes. This is 1 day after the second surgery. Here we can see the result 7 months after the total of 12,620 grafts. This is the donor area after extraction of approximately 50% from the follicular units. And the contact between the donor and the recipient area again. Donor area. Here you can see the density on the hairline and the frontal area. The density of the parietal area. The direction of the hair growing the vertex and the density again. This is the second case with total of 11,370 grafts. Whenever I plan to recover the hair of my patients, besides the anatomical characteristics, I am also interested in their social status and profession. For me, the good result is when the hair looks natural and inherent to the individual characteristics. In Bulgaria, this patient is a very popular producer with many social and media appearances. In his case, the technique of transplantation that I use allows me to achieve a great visual density in all affected areas. But the maximum density does not always mean perfect result. So in this case, the aim was to achieve a soft hairline, like a normal frontal retraction, with good density in the rest part of the recipient area. The result was achieved in 2 interventions. During the first intervention, I transplanted 7,720 grafts. 11 months after, in one surgical day, I transplanted another 3,650 grafts. The patient did not use any medical treatment to stimulate the hair growth after the surgery. The result, you see, is only due to the hair transplantation. This is the status of the patient before surgery, after marking the areas. And this is again the detailed information about the donor and the recipient area. The recipient area before surgery with microcamera photos. And again, the detailed information about the high and the low part of occipital area. The same information of the temporal area. And this is a detailed information about the first surgical day. In the first part of operation, I extracted 3,920 grafts from the right part of the donor area, and after 1 hour of rest, I implanted this amount in the back part of the recipient area. The total surgical time was 11 hours. This is the next surgical day. On this day, I extracted 3,800 grafts from the left part of the donor area, and I implanted this amount in the front part of the recipient area after 1 hour of rest. The total surgical time was 10 hours and 30 minutes. These are some of the grafts on this patient. the recipient in the donor area immediately after the surgery. This is the condition 12 days after the surgery. 11 months after transplantation of 7,720 grafts. This is the day on the second surgery. Immediately before the second surgery, after marking the areas. And this is a detailed information about the second surgery. During this surgery, I extracted 3,650 grafts, and I implanted this amount after 1 hour of rest. This is immediately after the second surgery, 10 days after. And this is the result of this patient, 10 months after transplantation of total of 11,370 grafts. You can see the hairline of the patient, soft hairline, like a normal frontal retraction. He is 49 years old, it's normal. This is a good density in the parietal area. And the donor area after extraction of approximately 40% from the follicular units. Donor area again, left and right, temporal area. If necessary, in this case, I can transplant 2,500 grafts more. And this is the density on the vertex and the direction of the hair grow. More photos of the hairline, the density on parietal area. And this is the temporal area and occipital area after extraction of approximately 40% from the follicular units. Again, donor area. And in the end, I want to thank this patient because despite his busy life, he has agreed to come with me and show his result to you. If you want, you can see him in person. This is the patient.
Hello, I am Mr. 11,000
grafts.
Yes, I am here, ladies and gentlemen, I am here to say hello everybody and thank you very much, Dr. Zarev. I am happy, I am real. Thank you very much.
Next speaker is Bill Rassman. He's also one of our special honored guests. I've known him almost 30 years. He's not quite old enough, though, but he's a legend. Here he comes on the history of FUE.
What a pleasure. Having seen that 11,000 graft case, I'm blown away. Very, very nice job. It certainly changed from when I started this thing. I have some conflicts of interest. I'm not going to go through them because I never quit. There's always a better way. I just want you to be aware of that. Here's a bridge that's out, and you can fly the cars across. You can create this creative bridge. Or you could be like most of us here, out-of-the-box thinkers, and there's a list of some great names. Pascal Boujima shouldn't be ignored. He actually envisioned this thing in 1991, which preceded almost all of us. And the rest are all legends in the business. And we're all out-of-the-box thinkers, and you have to be an out-of-the-box thinker here. The FUE itself has, in its evolution, has been quite a bit of out of the box. So Pascal Boujima invented, actually, and patented the first unit, Calvitron. It was a bit bigger grass. It wasn't quite fully FUE at the time. I saw it at FUE about the same time as Dr. Woods. I don't give Dr. Woods much credit because he was never open about it. And to me, it's very important to be open and share all our advances with everybody.